Welcome back to the Triple N. In October, some very old exhibits in a museum will start to move. But don't worry, they're not mummies, and they're only going to move once. The pieces are from the Norfolk Fire Rescue's own museum, and they're moving to a new home. Fire Department history will join with Police Department history in their very own building, where you'll be able to see all of it. Andy Mashaw has more.
Turnout gear, a lot of photographs, some other equipment that was used way back when.
Way back when can be a pretty powerful statement when you consider that the Norfolk Fire Department was established officially in 1871. Its history, though, can go back even further than that, like to Chief Thomas Cavell. He and other members of the United Fire Company from Norfolk served on board the CSS Merrimack, or Virginia. They actually fought in the Battle of the Ironclads. This is just some of the history found in the NFR Museum. Everything here was donated by NFR members. In 2003, Lieutenant Jim Bailey organized the collection and set it up in the training center on Granby Street.
We wanted to be able to put it on display to basically show the public and some of the younger members of the department where the department came from, and also be able to start being able to show where the department's going to.
Where the museum is going is here, 401 Freemason Street in downtown. Currently, it's the Freemason Street Reception Center and is operated by the Chrysler Museum. Come November, it will be the new home of a joint fire and police museum.
The people there, after finding out that the police department and the fire department were looking for a building to use as a museum, approached us, and we started laying the groundwork with a lot of assistance from the police department.
The real work will begin in October, when hundreds of pieces ranging from 1956 to 1995, from 2001 to 1871, will all be packed up and moved very carefully to their new home. And if you're wondering if their new home is a worthy place for all this history, let's introduce you to the neighbors. Across the street is the Freemason Street Baptist Church, built before 1879. And next door, the Moses Myers House was built in 1792. Lieutenant Bailey has a few ideas of how to fit NFR's history in with the rest, but he says for the museum to really work, he needs your help. Donations are needed to buy new cases and care for the exhibits. And beyond that,
the more input and involvement we can get from our members, it's a bigger way that our guys can take hold of and put some more pride back into the department and show off what we have.
For Norfolk News Now, I'm Andy Mashaw.
The new museum is set to open on November 1st.